جاهز ولا؟
نعم أخي تفضل. بارك الله فيك.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، أبدأ بسم الله مستعينا راد به مدبرا معينا. We begin in name of Allah, seeking His help, being pleased with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for He is the mu'in. كما قال الله عز وجل نعم المولى ونعم النصير. What a blessed helper He is, and a blessed one to give you victory. رَادٍ بِهِ. We are pleased with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as our Lord. And from the adiyah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is رَضَيْتُ بِاللَّهِ رَبًّا وَبِالْإِسْلَامِ دِينًا وَبِمُحَمَّدٍ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهُ وَسَلَّمْ نَبِيًّا. Being pleased with Allah as His Lord, as our Lord, and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as our messenger, and our deen as our way of life. رَادٍ بِهِ مُدَبِّرًا مُعِينًا. Allah is the mudabbir. كما قال الله عز وجل أَلَا لَهُ الْخَلْقُ وَالْأَمْرُ. So Allah belongs the creation and the affair, the command is with Him. أَلَا لَهُ الْخَلْقُ وَالْأَمْرُ. He is the mudabbir, subhanahu wa ta'ala, the plan of all affairs. All the affairs go back to Him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَا تَشَاءُونَ إِلَّا أَن يَشَاءَ اللَّهُ. Yes, you have will. And your will is under the will of Allah. And it's His mashi'a. Shaykh Rabi Hafidhullah explained, His mashi'a is from His rububiyya. You cannot get away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even if you try to run, you will run away to Allah. فَفِرُّ إِلَى اللَّهِ. You will never be able to run away, away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَالْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ كَمَا هَدَانَا إِلَى سَبِيلِ الْحَقِّ وَجْتَبَانَا. We praise Allah just as He has guided us to Tawheed and Sunnah, just as He has guided us to Islam, or the correct understanding of Islam, and the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the understanding of the Salaf al-Salih. Alhamdulillah. The believer always, he says, Alhamdulillah. عَجَبًا لِأَمْرِ الْمُؤْمِنِ إِنَّ أَمْرَهُ كُلَّهُ خَيْرٌ. The case of the believer is amazing. The Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the case of the believer is amazing. All of his affair is good. إِنْ أَصَابَهُ سَرَّى شَكَرْ فَكَانَ خَيْرًا لَهُ. If any good comes to him, he is grateful and that's good for him. وَإِنْ أَصَابَهُ ضَرَّى صَبَرْ فَكَانَ خَيْرًا لَهُ. And if any harm overcomes him or afflicts him, he is patient and that is good for him. So either way, he is blessed. Either way, the believer is amazing. He always says, Alhamdulillah, in good times and in bad times, in difficult times and in times of ease. Shaykh al-Albani rahimahullah said, the believer is like the saw. Both ways he is benefiting. When he's about to saw a piece of wood, both ways, to and fro, going and coming. The believer is always in benefit, always benefiting. Because he's upon the correct aqidah, al-aqidah sahiha, and he's upon the amal al-salih, according to the sunnah, righteous actions according to the sunnah of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So he is blessed upon khair. So alhamdulillah kama hadana. And hidayah is hidayatan. Qala Shaykh Salih Fawzan, guidance is of two types: hidayatul bayan wal irshad wa hidayatul tawfiq. As for hidayatul bayan wal irshad, this is clarifying the way. The prophets and the ulama, they clarified the way for the people to know Tawheed and Sunnah and to know how to do ibadah. So hidayatul bayan wal irshad is for the prophets and also for those ulama and those who call the people to good. This is hidayatul bayan wal irshad. As for hidayatul tawfiq, this is for Allah alone. This is for Allah alone. Ya Muhammad, لا تهدي من أحببت ولكن الله يهدي من يشاء. You cannot guide whom you will, but Allah guides whom He wills. Hidayat al-tawfiq. Allah puts that in your heart. Guides you to the right path. And Allah showed you both paths, good and bad. وَهَدَيْنَاهُ نَجْدَيْن. We've shown him the two paths. فَرِيقٌ فِي الْجَنَّةِ وَفَرِيقٌ فِي السَّعِيرِ. So everyone chooses his path. He's going to Jannah or Sa'ir, the hellfire. So here we have to praise Allah and thank Allah for guidance. Thank Allah and ask Allah continuously for guidance. Because just as He has guided you to Islam or the correct understanding of Islam, then you must ask Allah for thabat, to be on it until you meet Him. How many people left the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? How many people left the sunnah for bid'ah? How many people left tawheed for shirk? How many people left light for darkness? Ay wallah. We ask Allah to protect us and guide us. Ya muqallab al-qulub thabbit qulub ala deenak. We ask Allah to make our heart firm upon your deen, His deen. Because قلوب العباد بين أسبوعين من الصابر الرحمن يقلبه كيف يشاء. The hearts of the servants are between the two fingers of Ar-Rahman. He changes it how He wills. So we ask Allah for guidance continuously. So alhamdulillah kama hadana ila sabili al-haqq wajtabana. To the straight path. The straight path is, as Allah said, وَأَنَّ هَذَا صِرَاطِ مُسْتَقِيمًا فَاتَّبِعُوهُ وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا السُّبُلَ فَتَفَرَّقَ بِكُمْ عَنْ سَبِيلِهِ ذَلِكُمْ وَصَّاكُمْ بِهِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. The straight path is one path. Not two, not three, not five, not 72. One path. In a hadith which is Hassan. And the brothers, they have mentioned it in this leaflet. It's a good hadith with a good chain. The hadith of iftiraq. Iftaraqat al-Yahudu ala 71 firqa. The Jews split into 71 sects. Waftaraqat al-Nasara ala 72 firqa. They split into the Christians 72 sects. Wasataftariqu hadhihi al-Ummah ala 73 firqa. Will split up into 73 sects. Kulluha fi an-nar. All of it in the fire except one. They said which one? إلا واحدة. قالوا من هي رسول الله؟ قال من كان على مثل ما أنا عليه اليوم وأصحابي. That which I and my companions are upon. Hadith in Sunan Abi Dawood and is Hassan. It's a good chain. There is a master's or PhD thesis in Jam'a Islamiyya just on this hadith. One of the students, may Allah reward him, with the advice of the ulama, from the teachers in the Jam'a Islamiyya. Who has supervised it, two volumes, just on the hadith of Tiraq, because there are some sick people and some innovators, they don't like this hadith. Because they want everyone and anyone. Hodgepodge, mix and match. It doesn't matter, bid'ah, doesn't matter, whatever you're upon, let's all be accommodating of each and every one of us. Just like the motto of Hassan al-Banna, نتعاون فيما اتفقنا عليه. وَيُعْذِرُ بَعْضُنَا بَعْضًا فِي مَخْتَلَفْنَا فِيهِ. We cooperate in that which we agree upon, and we excuse each other in that which we disagree upon. And even in aqidah, even on issues of belief, and usul and manhaj and methodology, we excuse each other, no problem. La. The Prophet did not say that. He said, all in the fire except one. All in the fire means they are threatened with the fire. They are threatened with the fire except one, except the على طريقة أهل السنة وجماعة. The أهل الأثر, the سلفيون, the أهل الحديث. They are the one who are the saved sect. The sect which is aided by Allah Azza wa Jal, because Allah Azza wa Jal's messenger said, لا تزال طائفة من أمتي على الحق ظاهرين. They will not cease to be a group for my ummah, clearly upon the truth. لا يضرهم من خذلهم ولا من خالفهم حتى يأتي أمر الله وهم على ذلك. They will not be harmed by those who try to deceive them. Because they will not be able to deceive them. They are saved sect. They can smell their deception from far away. Because at the head of them, the ulama, they know the deception is coming. The deception of the innovators when they come with their innovations. When they come speaking against Sahaba radiallahu anhu, when they come causing doubt about the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when they come يعني, with all their innovations in manhaj and aqidah, the ulama, they know they are coming from far away. لا يضرهم من خذلهم ولا من خالفهم. Nor would they be harmed by those who oppose them. You see, for this one they oppose them. But the first one we said, as a correct translation, they try to deceive them because they will never be able to deceive them. Why? Because they are ta'ifatul mansura. And the head of them, the ulama, the likes of Shaykh Abdulaziz bin Baz, rahimullah, Shaykh Mu'taymin, rahimullah, and Shaykh Al-Albani, rahimullah, the head of this century. No doubt, because all the political activists were still in their kindergarten or nursery, if you like. Yes, they were still in there. How are they going to be the Mujaddidun? إن الله يبعث على رأس القرم من يجدد الأمة أمور دينها. حديث سنن أبي داود. Allah will raise at the head of the every century those who revive the deen as a whole. All the political activists that now have grown, they used to be in their nursery then. How are they going to be mujaddid if they are kids at the head of the century? At the head of the century, Sheikh, these three mashaykh that we mentioned, they were in their 60s already reviving the deen. Books on aqidah, books on ibadah, books on hadith, books on the tools of how to understand the deen, whether it's mustalah al-hadith, or whether it's usul fiqh, and qawa'id al-fiqhiyya, all of these tools to help you understand the deen of Allah, the nusus, the text. So alhamdulillah alladhi hadana. Eh wallah, alhamdulillah. Because some people, they went astray. They went with the Sufis, some with the Shia, some with the Brelvis, some with the Diobandis, and all these different groups, Tablighis, and Ikhwanis, and Qutubis, and Sururis. All them went with these groups, Takfiris, the so-called Jihadis. Everyone is, and when you look at who they are, and who they are, what is their foundation, you find the foundation is corrupt. They have no foundation that is firmly rooted and established. Quran, والسنه على فهم السلف الصالح. The last one, they miss it out. Or they cut and paste. على, and not just in عقيدة and manhaj, but also in عباده, you find them missing it out. على فهم السلف الصالح. ما في. Cut and paste. But with these three we mentioned, and those who follow them upon righteousness, from the likes of Sheikh Saleh bin Fawzan, Al-Fawzan, and Sheikh Al-Haydan, and Sheikh Rabi bin Hadi, and Sheikh Ubaid al-Jabir, and Sheikh Muhammad bin Hadi, and Sheikh Abdul Muhsin in Madi, we find a lot of khair, reviving Tawheed and Sunnah. This is what they are reviving. Sheikh Abdul Muhsin finished all of the 6 books of Hadith. In one book of Hadith is about 4,000 Hadith. So imagine 6 books, how many thousands of Hadith he has covered in 26 years, and only to start again from the beginning. Naam. And the other Mashaykh, they have already in the last 10 years in Medina, they have the likes of Sheikh Ubaid already finished Umdat al-Ahkam, Lu'lu' al-Marjan, yani the Ibadat, all of the Ibadat in Lu'lu' al-Marjan, in Bulugh al-Maram, in Manhaj al-Salikin, in Umdat al-Fiqh, and in Aqidah, books of Sheikh Ibn Taymiyyah, Al-Wasatiyya, Ahamawiyya, Tudmuriyya, these other books by other Mashaykh, they've been taught, and the books of Muhammad Wahab, the reviving those books, and the books of Imam Ahmad, Rahimullah, Usul al-Sunnah, Imam Ahmad, and the Sunnah of Ibn Abi Asim, and other books, and Asl al-Sunnah of Imamain al-Raziyain, from the 3rd century, Abu Hatim al-Razi, and Abu Zur'a al-Razi, and the other, na'am. Why did they revive these books? Because the Takfiris, and the people of misguidance, the Sufis, the Takfiris, they have gone astray. They don't know these books. Wallahi, one Takfiri, we said to him, you don't know Usul al-Sunnah? He says, no. So that's why you are Takfiri. Because if you read Usul al-Sunnah, the first line is what? Tamassak. What's the first line? Usul al-Sunnah indana. التمسك بما كان عليه أصحاب رسول الله. This is what إجماع. What they were upon is Deen. أمتي لا تجتمع للضلالة. So they were upon those who are going through the books of like أصول السنة of Imam Ahmad. They are holding on to Nas والإجماع. Quran والسنة and إجماع. شاء الله على بركة الله. Whoever wants to go, no need to ask me, just go. Because you may have a particular appointment or something. No problem. No problem. Al-amr fihi sa'a. The affair is easy, inshallah. So therefore, going back to the usul. These misguided groups, they don't go back to these usul. And you find them having no ulama with them. Rather, they are the ones who call themselves or refer to themselves as the muftis and as the ones who are going to solve the problems of the ummah. You going to solve the problem of the ummah with your misguidance, with your misunderstanding, with your ignorance, with your disease of speaking and reviling the ulama? How are you going to? Like Hizb al-Tahrir al-Muhajirun, they used to put orange stickers And sometimes you wonder how they got up the top of the lamppost to put that orange sticker there. Yani, so much effort to put an orange sticker. Yani, sometimes if you're driving on the motorway and it's right at the top of the bridge. How did he get up there? SubhanAllah, but he can't pray. He can go up there on top of a lamppost to put an orange sticker, but he doesn't know the sunnah of how to pray. How are you going to establish Islamic State? You can't even establish the salah. Azzaqimu salat li dhikri. Establish this prayer for my remembrance. You can't even do that. Aqimu salat li duduki shamsi ila ghasaqi layl. Wa Qur'an al-fajr. Inna Qur'an al-fajr kana mashhuda. They don't even establish that which Allah has established upon the sunnah of Rasulullah ﷺ, but he can put an orange stick on top of a lamppost. Ay deen hada? Is this the deen of the Anbiya wal Mursaleen? And the deen of the Sahaba radiallahu anhum? They all started with themselves. قُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ وَأَهْلِيكُمْ نَارًا وَقُودُوهَا النَّاسُ وَالْحِجَارَةِ. Save yourself and your families, whose fuel is men and stone. Whose fuel is men and stone. عَلَيْهَا مَلَائِكَةٌ غِلَاظٌ شِدَادٌ لَا يَعْصُونَ اللَّهَ مَا أَمَرَهُمْ وَيَفْعَلُونَ مَا يُؤْمَرُونَ. Upon that, يعني, as guardians are angels who are mighty and stern. And they do not go against the commandments of Allah when they are ordered and when they are commanded. So therefore it's a test for us. This life is a test for us. Are we going to follow the Rasulullah ﷺ? We claim to love him, but we don't know his seerah. We claim to love him, but we don't follow him. The one who said he loves Rasulullah ﷺ, the ayatul imtihan has been sent to him. قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهَ فَاتَّبِعُونِ يُحْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهُ وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ وَاللَّهُ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. Say, if you truly love Allah, then follow me. And Allah will love you. Allahu Akbar. You want Allah's love? Follow Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. يُحْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهُ وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ. And he will forgive you your sins. وَاللَّهُ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. And Allah is all forgiving, most merciful. Love in the sunnah. إِنَّ الْمُحِبَّ لِمَنْ يُحِبُّ مُطِيعُ. As the poet said, that the one who truly loves someone, he follows him, he obeys him. The Sahaba, they loved Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Even if they didn't know why he did a particular action, they would just do it because of love for Rasulullah ﷺ. The cousin of Rasulullah ﷺ, Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anh, he loved Rasulullah ﷺ. And we know how much the Messenger ﷺ loved him. But look how much he loved Rasulullah ﷺ. He loved Allah that he would follow Rasulullah ﷺ in whatever Rasulullah ﷺ would do, even if he didn't understand it. For example, the dua of Rukub al-Dabba, the dua of boarding a transport, it was reported by Ali radiallahu anhu. And at the end of that dua, the Prophet ﷺ would say, فَغْفِرْ لِي فَإِنَّهُ لَا يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ إِلَّا أَنْتَ. Forgive me, for none forgives but sins but you. And he would say this. And then smile. Then smile. After saying, he would smile. They said to Ali radiallahu anhu, why do you smile after this dua? He said, I saw Rasulullah ﷺ smile after saying it, so I smiled. He doesn't even know why. Allahu Akbar. He just saw Rasulullah smile after saying this dua. When you board a form of transport, whether it is a riding beast or a car or a plane or a train, whatever it is, Allahu Akbar. He just, they went to Rasulullah. Why do you smile after saying this? And this hadith is in Kalim al-Tayyib, is Sahih Kalim al-Tayyib. Kalim al-Tayyib is adhkar book by Ibn Taymiyyah. And the Sahih of it is Sheikh Albani rahimahullah put it in the Sahih small compilation. Sahih Kalim al-Tayyib. At the end, they went to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Why do you smile after saying this dua? فَاخْفِرْلِي فَإِنَّهُ لَا يَغْفِرُ الدُّنُوبَ إِلَّا أَنْتَ. He said, I smile because Allah loves those who say this. And because Allah knows that none can forgive but Him. Allahu Akbar. None can فَاخْفِرْلِي. So forgive me, O Allah. For none can forgive but you. Allah loves that you say this. Allah, because He knows that no one can forgive but Him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not the one in the grave, dead, deceased. Not the stars, not the stones, not the talisman. They're relying upon Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَاغْفِرْلِي فَإِنَّهُ لَا يَغْفِرُ الدُّنُوبَ إِلَّا أَنْتَ. And every time we say this dua, we also smile. اتِّبَاعًا لِرَسُولِ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهِ وَسَلَّمْ. Following the example of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Do we find this with the misguided groups? No. We find them innovating the opposite of love. You truly love Allah? Follow Rasulullah. They do the opposite. They go against what the Rasulullah ﷺ, by adding celebrating his birthday. He didn't do it. Not the Sahaba, not the Tabi'in, not the Tabi Tabi'in. The Shia Rafid of the 4th century, Fatimiyin of Egypt, they innovated it. And so you are following, and your leaders are the Shia of Rafida of Egypt, the Fatimiyin, who innovated this practice of Milad al-Nabi. And how many other innovations we see and we hear about in our everyday lives between these misguided groups. So going back to Allah and His Rasul and loving the Rasul by following him, not by imitating. So alhamdulillah kama hadana. Ay wallah alhamdulillah. We ask Allah for thabat. We ask Allah for ikhlas. We were studying with Sheikh Rabi' Hafidhullah when we were in Jeddah. We used to travel 3 days a week. Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. The Sheikh would be given classes on Thursday and Friday. Kitab al-Tawheed, Fath al-Majid. And on Friday, he would be doing Ba'ith al-Hadith and Sharia. And every time we go to the class, he's always saying, Nas'al Allah thabat wal-ikhlas. Nas'al Allah thabat wal-ikhlas. Nas'al Allah thabat wal-ikhlas. Nearly every single lesson, we ask Allah to be firm upon the truth and to have sincerity. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. All those years, and even when we visit him now, he still says the same. Nas'al Allah thabat wal-ikhlas. Because, ya ikhwan, without ikhlas, with only one of these, you're not going to succeed. Without ikhlas, وَمَا أُمِرُوا إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُ اللَّهَ مُخْلِصِينَ لَهُ الدِّينَ. They have not been commanded except to worship Allah sincerely in His religion. أَلَا لِلَّهِ الدِّينُ الْخَالِصِ. To Allah belongs the sincere religion. Without ikhlas, you're upon shirk. Without ikhlas, you do actions for other than Allah. You end up in the hellfire forever. Without yani doing things for Allah's sake, doing things with shirk in your ibadah. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So ikhlas wallahi is a big trial, a big mountain to climb, each and every one of us checking himself every single day that we don't do things for the people. What can the people benefit you anyway? What can they give you? Allah is the one who has the kingdom of the heavens and the earth. Allahumma Malik al-Muluk, he's the King of Kings, subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's the Malik, he's the Quddus, he's the Salam al-Mu'min, al-Muhaymin, al-Aziz, al-Jabbar, al-Mutakabbir. He's the Almighty, the Compeller, the one who's the all-proud, na'am. Whoever competes with him with his pride, he breaks him. The Prophet said that Allah said Hadith Qudsi, which is Sahih, whoever competes with my pride, I break him. Allahu Akbar, qasamtuhu, I break him. No way. You will get away with being arrogant and proud in rejecting the nusu, in rejecting the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and get away with it. No. We found in Bukhari there's a narration, a man who was walking on the earth and he was swallowed up because he was arrogant. He was proud and haughty. And Allah said, وَلَا تَمْشِي فِي الْأَرْضِ مَرَحًا. Don't go in the land full of pride. إِنَّكَ لَن تَخْرِقَ الْأَرْضَ. وَلَنْ تَبْلُغَ الْجِبَالَ طُولًا. That's in Surah Al-Isra. You did not penetrate the earth, nor did you reach the mountain in height. So what are you proud of? Did you reach the mountain in height? You take weeks to get to the top. So what are you proud of? What are you proud for? Secondly, Allah said in Surah Luqman, وَلَا تَمْشِي فِي الْأَرْضِ مَرَحًا. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُحِبُّ كُلَّ مُخْتَالٍ فَخُورٍ. Allah doesn't love every proud, boastful, arrogant person. Person who boasts, I did, and I fa'alt, wa sawait, wa ma'amalt. Yani, he's only there for show. He's not there for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And how many times we hear people like that, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who are there in order to gain status in society because maybe they want extra money, they want wealth, they want women, they want dunya. This is what they do. They manipulate societies. Yes, they may translate books, but look at their life, maybe married 15 times, because they're moving from community to community, spoiling communities and spoiling families and family units and societies. Na'am, this is what's occurring. This is what's happening. Because why? Adam al-ikhlas wa adam al-ittiba'. Of course, ikhlas is a matter of the heart. We don't open the heart, the people's heart. But from their actions, you can see that they are cheating and lying and that they are dishonest. So this is not for the sake, this is not sincere for Allah's path. There are apparent things clearly showing the individual is corrupt in what they are doing. And some people even claim to be scholars. Wallahi, they used to come to this country, this Egyptian one who came to this country. And now what happened to, what was he doing then? He was, he's got credit cards, fraud. Credit cards, that stolen credit cards, and he's using it while he's giving da'wah. MashaAllah, tabarakAllah. He's talking to the people about being good to the parents, and he's crying in the talk and this. Now they have website, stopmajdiwarda.com. They have a whole website just to stop him. Huh? Because he's been from England, when he rigged the money here, and the women and so on, got the whatever he could get, he's gone to America now, take whatever he can get as well. Ikhlas, ikhlas, and ittiba'. Without these two, Allah will expose you. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also will humiliate you because you chose the life of this world for the akhirah. وَمَا حَيَاتُ الدُّنْيَا إِلَّا لَعِبٌ وَلَهُ وَلَدَّارُ الْآخِرَةُ خَيْرُ الَّذِينَ يَتَّقُونَ أَفَلَا تَعْقِلُونَ. نعم. What is this world but playing as an amusement? And the abode of the hereafter is better for the pious ones. أَفَلَا تَعْقِلُونَ. The abode of the hereafter is khair. Khair liman? Khair lilmuttaqeen. For the ones who are pious. نعم. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned, مَتَاعٌ قَلِيلٌ. This life is mata'un qaleel, just amusement that is short and is little, is not long everlasting. ثم مأواهم جهنم, then their end result will be the hellfire. نسأل الله السلامة. وبئس المهاد, what evil abode and place that is, as a place of rest for these individuals. نعم, nobody gets away with it, ya akhwan. Everybody is going to be accountable for whatever they put. An atom's weight of a deed, you will see it. Of good or bad. Mata'un qaleel. Thumma ma'wahum jahannam. Wa bisal mihad. Wallahi, we're amazed with these people. How? Don't they read Quran? Because if you read Quran, you will see the authority of Allah. And you will see that the khasirin alladhina khasiru anfusahum wa alihim yawm al-qiyama. Thalika huwa al-khusranul mubin. If you read Quran, you will see that you will be the loser. If you turn away from the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you try to manipulate societies for your own benefit, you will be the loser. Not only yourself and your family. لَكِنَّ الَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا. But those who are pious. تَقَوْا رَبَّهُمْ لَهُمْ جَنَّاتٌ تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِهَا الْأَنْهَارِ. They will have paradise where rivers flow. نعم. And Sheikh Salih Fawzan says, rivers of honey and rivers of milk. Rivers of honey, so pure. You don't have to even go so too far away to get it. It's right in front of you. Ease. With ease. Rivers of honey. Rivers of milk. Not like the milk in this life, which goes off after a day or two. You have to keep it in the fridge or whatever, and it will go off after a while if the sell-by date goes. But in Jannah, it doesn't go off. And it's pure. And it's tasty. And it's khalidina fiha. And they will be in the paradise forever. Nuzulan min indillah. It is from Allah, sent down from Allah. وَمَا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ خَيْرٌ لِلْأَبْرَارِ. And what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has is khair. وَاللَّهِ خَيْرٌ لِلْأَبْرَارِ. For the righteous ones, it is khair, it is good, and it is better. وَإِنَّ مِنْ أَهْلِ الْكِتَابِ لَمَنْ يُؤْمِنُ. Until the end of that surah. So here we have فَرِيقٌ فِي الْجَنَّةِ وَفَرِيقٌ فِي السَّعِيرِ. So alhamdulillah كَمَا هَدَانَا إِلَى سَبِيلِ الْحَقِّ وَجَتَبَانَا. وَاخْتَارَنَا وَجَتَبَانَا بِمَعْنَى وَاخْتَارَنَا. He chose this path for us. And he chose us to be on this path. And there are few followers. قَلِيلٌ مِنْ عِبَادِيَ الشَّكُورِ. It's not about the numbers. Some people think it's a large amount of people. That means they are upon the right. That's what the kuffar used to say. And that is the Masail Jahiliyyah that Muhammad Abdul Wahhab rahimahullah mentioned in Masail Jahiliyyah. Is that the pagans, the Jahiliyyah people, and the disbelieving people, they used to say, it's about numbers. It's about the majority. No, Ya Abdullah. It's about the haqq. Qala ibn Mas'ud, radiyallahu anhu, al-jama'atu ma wafaqa al-haqq walau kunta wahdak. The jama'ah is whatever's upon the truth, even if you be on your own. One, two, three followers, no problem. If it's haqq, it's haqq. A prophet will come on the Day of Judgment with only a few followers, between 3 and 9. Another one will come with only 2 or 1. And some prophets will come with no followers. So it's not about in na'am the numbers. Allah said, لا تجد أكثر الناس ولو حرصت بمؤمنين. You will not find, even if you try your best, you will not find most of the people believers, true believers. Most of mankind, you will find them astray. So we don't look for the numbers. Alhamdulillah, kama hadana ila sabil al-haqq wa jtabana. Ahmaduhu subhanahu wa ashkuruhu wa min musawi amal yastaghfiruhu. Ahmaduhu, na'am, subhanahu. High is Allah from imperfection. Allah has beautiful names and attributes. He has beautiful names that He has named Himself with. And they are not limited to 99, but rather He has names that He hasn't told us about. As for the hadith in Muslim, hadith of Abi Hurairah radhiyallahu anhu, Allah has 99 names, yes, that He has told us about. But there are others that He hasn't told us about. And as for the narration in Sunan Abi Dawud, which actually mentions what the names are, that narration is not authentic. Na'am. Rather, it has been left for the ulama to make ijtihad as to what those names are. And Shaykh Ibn Uthaymeen rahimahullah has mentioned, يعني, to the best of his ability, in Qawa'id al-Muthla, 99 names. And Shaykh Abdul Muhsin Abdullah, likewise, in his explanation of Al-Qirwaniya, he's mentioned as well 99 names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He differed with the Ibn Uthaymeen rahimahullah only about two or three names. So here we have the ulama trying their best to find out what those names are out of ijtihad. But as for other names, Allah did not tell us about those other names. They are with Him in His knowledge, with Him. And we don't know. Allahu A'lam. But it's not limited to 99. This is what the ulama mentioned in explanation of that hadith. From them is Shaykh Abdul Muhsin and Shaykh Ubaid and Shaykh Rabi' and Shaykh and others. They all mentioned it. And Shaykh Nu'taymin, they all mentioned this fa'ida. So, Alhamdulillah. Ahmaduhu Subhanah. So we have to say Subhanallah. Alhamdulillah. وَلَا إِلَهِ اللَّهِ وَاللَّهُ أَكْبَرُ. This is sadaqah for you. Coming to the masjid is sadaqah for you. And leaving and smiling in your brother's face is charity for you. Subhanallah. This is how the believer is. Welcoming your guest. All of these are good deeds. And Subhanallah, dhikr. وَلَذِكْرُ اللَّهِ أَكْبَرُ. And the dhikr of Allah is the greatest. وَالذَّاكِرِينَ اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا وَالذَّاكِرَاتِ أَعَدَّ اللَّهُ لَهُمْ مَغْفِرَةً وَأَجْرًا عَظِيمًا. Those who remember Allah much, Allah has prepared for them maghfirat and forgiveness and a great reward. So how are we in the morning and in the night? Because Allah said, وَاصْبِرْ نَفْسَكَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ يَدْعُونَ رَبَّهُمْ بِالْغَدَاتِ وَالْعَشِيِّ يُرِيدُونَ وَجْهَهُ. Morning and night, you are patient, He says. They are patient, the righteous ones, they are patient morning and night. With who? With those who are calling upon their Lord. Morning and night, they are calling upon their Lord. يُرِيدُونَ وَجْهَ, seeking His face. Morning and night. In the morning, they get up for their prayer, doing the best of the, from the best of the prayer, Salat al-Fajr, when nobody sees them, in the darkness, they go out. Maybe it's cold. Maybe the water is cold. And they do the wudu. They go out without fidgeting. They go out to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and say the dhikr in the morning of going to the masjid. After they leave their house, they're saying, Allahumma ja'al fi qalbi nura, wa ja'al fi sam'i nura, wa basari nura, wa amami nura, wa min khalfi nura, wa an yamini nura, wa min shimali nura, wa min fawqi nura, wa min tahti nura. Allahumma a'tini nura. Oh Allah, give me guidance. That is the light that they're asking for, is guidance. And then as they enter the masjid, they enter and they say, A'udhu billahi al-azim. بوجه الكريم وسلطان القديم من الشيطان الرجيم. If you say that, Shaitan will not bother you, will not harm you until the evening. And that particular dua is specifically for Fajr. بسم الله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. اللهم افتح لي أبواب رحمتك. That's for any other time. Sending salah upon Rasulullah. Look at the state of that believer, subhanallah. And then he's praying with the one who prays Fajr in Jama'ah, فَإِنَّهُ تَحْتَ ذِمَّةِ اللَّهِ. He's under the protection of Allah until the evening. Allahu Akbar. And then he prays his salawat al-khams. He tries his best to be in the masjid. And he prays his whatever he is able to pray from extra prayers. And then when he goes to sleep and he says, in the hadith in Bukhari, بِسْمِكَ رَبِّي وَضَعْتُ جَنْبِي وَبِكَ أَرْفَعُهُ إِنْ أَمْسَكْتَ نَفْسِي فَغْفِرْ لَهَا وَإِنْ أَرْسَلْتَهَا فَحْفَظْهَا. He's asking Allah for protection. He's protected in the morning. When he goes to sleep, he's asking for Allah for protection. فَحْفَظْهَا بِمَا تَحْفَظُ بِهِ عِبَادَكَ الصَّالِحِينَ. He's asking Allah for protection. إن أمسكت نفسي فاغفر له وإن أرسلتها فاحفظها بما تحفظ بعبادك الصالحين. He's asking Allah to protect his soul. Allahu Akbar. So in the night he's asking and he reads Ayatul Kursi before he sleeps. Allah places an angel for you to protect you until the morning. And the angels are stronger than the jinn. The angels are stronger than the jinn. So why are you afraid of shaitan? Some people, they're afraid of shaitan. Say, oh, no, why? You have been given the dhikr of Allah. You have been given those who will aid you to protect yourself from shaitan. So, and how many times we hear communities complaining, this one has got magic, and this one has got this problem, and this one's got waswas, whispers, and this one. How are you with the dhikr of Allah in the first place? وَلَا ذِكْرُ اللَّهِ أَكْبَرُ. So use the dhikr of Allah to protect yourself. So alhamdulillah kama hadana ila sabili al-haq wa jtabana ahmaduhu subhanahu ashkuruh wa min musawi amali astaghfiruh. And we seek forgiveness. We seek forgiveness for our sins as well as we ask Allah. We should be grateful to what Allah has given us. Ay wallah, Allah has given you family. Before that he's guided you to Islam or in Islam. Ni'mah. Wa in ta'uddu ni'matullahi la tuhsuha. If you were to count the blessings of Allah, you'll not be able to count the blessing. You will not be able to count it. Na'am. And there are many verses like that. فَبِأَيِّ أَلَاءِ رَبِّكُمَا تُكَذِّبُونَ وَمَا تُكَذِّبَانَ. So which of the favors of your Lord do you deny? Which of the favors? There are many favors. One after the other. Favors of your health. Favors of you, yani, of sustenance and provisions. Of being fed and clothed and sheltered. Allahu Akbar. All of that. Even when you are sleeping, Allah is taking care of you. And your heart is beating. And your liver is working. And your kidneys are working. Subhanallah, your digestive system is working. And Allah makes it easy for you to use even the most difficult thing for you, maybe for some people when they get older, to use the bathroom. All of that, Ya Abdullah, for you. And it gives you children. It gives you wealth. Al-malu wal-banuna zinatul hayati dunya. But what is better than that? والباقيات الصالحات خير عند ربك ثوابا وخير املا. Better than that is your باقيات الصالحات, calling upon your Lord and doing dhikr of Allah, subhanallah walhamdulillah wa la ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, and your amal as-salih, your righteous actions. Who is it that is reminding us of all this except the ulama? The ulama of Ahl al-Sunnah, the ulama of Tawheed. They are the ones who uphold Tawheed. They are the ones who remind us of this. Alhamdulillah, Allah did not leave us alone. We are connected with the ulama. As for the Ahl Bid'ah, they are disconnected from the ulama of Ahl Sunnah. And who they just propped anyone up. Why don't you be the alim? Like one of them said in Canada, we don't really have to look far away. We don't really have to go all the way to Medina and all the way to Mecca and all the way to Riyadh. We don't really need to do that. This miskeen who said this. Ma fi faham. Fi faham bas. You know, faham is coal. That's all there is, coal. No faham, only faham. We don't have to go to the ulama. Well, then he looks at somebody who's memorized a little bit. He says to him, or even if you memorize a lot, that is not proof of understanding. That is not proof of having correct methodology. That is not proof. If you memorize the whole Quran, the whole of Bukhari, the whole of Muslim, that's not proof. And you can still look at Abdurrahman bin Muljam. He memorized the whole Quran and he was Khariji in the end. He went out and he was of those who killed Ali radiallahu anhu. Abdurrahman bin Muljam, this Khariji. Initially he was a Quran teacher, having memorized the whole Quran. So what's the benefit of memory if you don't understand? If you don't have fahm, you only have fahm. What's the benefit? So he says this jahil from I think he's from Australia or Canada. Anyway, he was in Canada at the time, this masjid. This was about 10 years ago. And he said, well, we don't really need to go, you know, to the ulama. We have someone right here. Allahu Akbar. Someone right here, right next to him. He didn't, you know. MashaAllah. MashaAllah. So when there's nawazil, when there are issues that affect the whole ummah, you're going to go to him? He's going to solve the whole problem of the whole ummah. When we have big problems, which is going to be bloodshed or no, you're going to go to him. And you're going to go to those political activists who caused so much harm, who were reasons for more than 100,000 people being killed in Algeria, because they said there is jihad in Algeria and they got it wrong. They got it wrong. Because why? They didn't have the strength. Why you call for jihad? Don't have the strength. You have the ability. The flag needs to be clear. And so what happened, the end result? They didn't listen to Sheikh Al-Bani, they didn't listen to Sheikh Ibn Uthaymeen, they didn't listen to Sheikh Ibn Baz, they didn't listen to Sheikh Rabi bin Hadi at that time, no, Sheikh Salih Fawzan, they didn't listen to these great scholars. So what happened? More than 100,000 people got killed. A son will kill his own father because he's a policeman. Because he's making takfir of the ruler and he's making takfir of his own father. And he's killing him. A'udhu billah. This jahl, this ignorance. And ignorance is a reason for, could be a reason for you killing somebody unjustly. So this is why we have to learn our deen. Rabbi zidni ilma. We have to go back to qala Allah, qala Rasulullah, qala Sahaba. As Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah said in his Nunniyya. Going back to qala Allah, qala Rasulullah, qala Sahaba. Wa in ikhtalaftum, farudduhu ila Allah wa Rasul. In kuntum tu'minuna billahi wal yawmil akhir. If you differ amongst yourselves, then refer back to Allah and His Messenger. If you truly believe in Allah, if you truly believe in Allah and the last day, ذَلِكَ خَيْرٌ وَأَحْسَنُ تَأْوِيلًا, that is better for you. And the best understanding in the affair is to go back to Allah and His Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم. تَرَكْتُ فِيكُمْ أَمْرَيْنِ مَا إِنْ تَمَسَّكْتُمْ بِهِمَا لَنْ تَضِلُّ بَعْدِ أَبَدًا كِتَابَ اللَّهُ وَسُنَّتِي. So who is calling you to this أمرين؟ قال الله قال رسول. Who is calling you to that? The ulama. And as for the one who are the ulama, we mentioned them. And they are the ulama of Tawheed. شهد الله أنه لا إله إلا هو والملائكة وأولو العلم قائما بالقسط. They teach Tawheed. They explain to you Tawheed is three categories. Rububiyya, Uluhiyya, Asma, Sifat. And they explain in detail what the kalima of Tawheed is. لا إله إلا الله لا معبود بحق إلا الله. None has the right to be worshipped except Allah. And they explain the second part of the kalima. Muhammadun Rasulullah. طاعته فيما أمر اجتنابه طاعته فيما أمر تصديقه فيما أخبر واجتناب ما نهى عنه وزجر. And that you do not do an act except with the شرع that he legislated, يعني from Allah. This is what the Rasul came with, and this is what he came to teach the people. So وأن لا يعبد الله إلا بما شرع. That Allah is not worshipped except that which He legislated, except that which He came with from the Sunnah of Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. So Tawheed, ya du'at al-Islam, al-Tawheed awwalan, Tawheed comes first. وَلَقَدْ بَعَثْنَا فِي كُلِّ أُمَّةٍ رَسُولًا أَنْ يَعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ وَاجْتَنِبُوا الطَّاغُوتَ. So they call to Tawheed first, worshipping Allah alone first, ikhlas, because wallahi we need this reminder. Much of the ummah, unfortunately, has fallen into ignorance of shirk, fallen into ignorance of worshipping other than Allah. I give you many examples. In Oman, a brother was telling me he saw people doing tawaf around the graves, sacrificing at the graves. In Morocco, similar. In Morocco, in Fas, the city of Fas, people going to Na'am Mulayhum al-Idris. They go to someone they call يعني, a righteous individual, supposedly. They go to him. Doesn't benefit me. Benefit and harm, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala we go to for benefit. We ask for his benefit. But there, what do they do? Wallahi, ya akhwan. One brother, يعني, he mentioned that they put it on YouTube or they recorded it. They recorded it. What they do on that day? When they go to, it's like a hajj for them. They go to his grave. And they bring a large bull. Naam. And it's like a whole ceremony. People playing their tunes and everything. All the way to the grave. When they get to the grave, he said they don't even sacrifice the bull. They just hit it. And then the blood comes out, all of it. So it's not even sacrificed in a sharia way. They just hit it until the blood comes out. And you get all, and he said, I saw these little guys come in, and they all just put their head right inside the flesh, the raw flesh of the bull, just to eat the flesh raw. Look at these people, Yahya. Aishada. And in Egypt, how many mosques that have graves inside? Masjid Fatima, they call it in Cairo. with a grave inside. وأن المساجد لله فلا تدع مع الله أحدا. The masajid are for Allah. So don't call besides Allah anyone else. And in Pakistan and in India, how many graves raised above the ground? The Prophet ﷺ hadith, hadith al-Tabi'i, عن أبي هياج الأسدي, قال لعلي بن أبي طالب رضي الله عنه, ألا أبعثك على ما بعثني رسول صلى الله عليه وسلم, ألا تدع تمثالا إلا طمسته ولا قبرا مشرفا إلا سويته. قبر, حديث صحيح مسلم, قبر مشرفا, قبر that is raised above the ground, you level it. Just like now, Baqi'. You know Baqi'? It didn't used to be like that. Baqi', go into the encyclopedia and you see how, yani, in, what do you call it? Nowadays they call it Google search, huh? Now you can find many things in the past, what, history. What did they? Used to be domes over the graves. People call it, but now, alhamdulillah, with the da'wah of Muhammad Abdul Wahhab, rahimullah, may Allah have mercy on him, you see they leveled. It's all leveled now. So that there's no one that the people go and seek blessings from. And still you get people like Rafida and that seeking certain graves. You go to different countries, you see ajaib. My brother said he went to Sudan and the same thing. He saw people sacrificing at the grave. Sacrificing. Allah says, Inna salati wa nusuki wa mahyaya wa mamati lillah. My prayer, my sacrifice, my life, my death for Allah alone. لا شريك له وبذلك أمرت وأنا أول المسلمين. That which I have been commanded and I'm the first of the Muslims. So who are the ones who are calling us to Tawheed? The ulama of Ahl al-Sunnah, the ulama of Ahl al-Athar, the Salafiyun, bringing you قال الله قال رسول الله. But Ahl al-Bid'ah, no, they won't talk about this, because فاقد شيء لا يعطيه. The one who doesn't have it can't give it. It's true. Shaykh Al-Bani used to say that what you don't have, you can't give. And he said about those individuals, there were some that used to be with us, they left. About those, subhanallah, how can you, أَتَسْتَبْدِلُ الَّذِي هُوَ أَدْنَى بِالَّذِي هُوَ خَيْرٌ. Are you going to change that which is يعني, better for something which is worse? And Shaykh Al-Bani, he said, كُنَّا تَحْتَ الْمَطَرْ فَصِلْنَا تَحْتَ الْمَزَارِبِ. We were under the rain, and then we became under the drains. For those people, it's still water, but it's polluted water now. Now it's polluted water. It's bid'ah now they're on. Before, they maybe tasted, smelled some sunnah, smelled some, but now it's bid'ah and khurafa, superstition. And Shaykh Al-Bani, when he refutes, wallahi, mashallah, tabarakallah, he says, the batil that some of these people are on, batil lahu qarnan, batil with two horns, not just one horn, it's real batil. So going back to the ulama of Ahl al-Sunnah, they are the ones who are teaching the people Tawheed and Sunnah. They are the ones reviving the correct Aqeedah in Allah and His angels and His books and His messengers and the last day and the Qadr, good and bad. And that is, Allah mentioned, He raised them. نعم يرفع الله الذين آمنوا منكم والذين أوتوا العلم درجات. He raises them many levels. And those who have been given knowledge. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, likewise, He mentioned that they are the ones who fear Allah the most. يخشى إنما يخشى الله من عباده العلماء. They are the ones who fear Allah the most. When people are sleeping, they are in the night praying. نعم, because تتجافى جنوبهم عن المضاجع. They leave resting their sides upon the beds. For what? For the dhikr of Allah. Because the more they know, the more they become fearful and hope to meet their Lord. This is the ulama. As we have mentioned, some of them and their like, may Allah reward them. Wallahi, may Allah reward them. We say that sincerely, having love for them. Why? Because, ya ikhwan, wallahi, if you see their life, giving their life for Allah, giving their life for the da'wah, giving their life for reviving Tawheed and Sunnah, giving their life for correcting errors and bid'ah, giving their life, subhanAllah, in Saudi Arabia, for example, many, yani, you have newspapers, now you have some modernists and some people writing in these newspapers, and who do you have dealing with them and dealing with their errors and so on? Sheikh Saleh Fawzan and Sheikh Rabih, from the examples. May Allah reward them. Continuously writing. If there's an issue that comes up, somebody said something that's wrong, and like you had somebody who's supposed to memorize the whole Quran. The whole Quran is supposed to have memorized, yes? But what's the benefit if he's saying that yani music is allowed? How? What is it? Where are yani? أين أنت؟ أين أنت؟ Where are you from the from the dhikr of Allah. You want the people to go to the music? You memorize Quran, ish faida if you're going to call the people to the Quran, ya akhi. Call them to memorize the Quran, the book of Allah. No, music is allowed. Then he tries to bring doubts, narration, even worse. Now you're trying to make it allowed in with the shubuhat, with doubts. Masallallahu salama. And the other one, now this is supposed to be somebody who was known, a known reciter. And they start saying that music is allowed. So we had the mashayikh refuting them. And then we had another one saying about free mixing is allowed. Free mixing is allowed. MashaAllah, tabarakAllah. For his family it's not allowed, but for others it's allowed. MashaAllah, tabarakAllah. So we are ikhwan. Wallahi, ikhwan, we find the ulama always. And before the sins, we find them first and foremost refuting the bid'ah. And they advise. Those who used to be with them, or outwardly they used to be with them, they advise them. How many times we found that they advise? Like Sheikh Rabi advising those who went astray. Nowadays they went further astray. How many times they used to advise them secretly, sending them letters, speaking to them one-to-one, sending the students to talk to them. But then they became arrogant, these individuals. Because they take money under the table. And money talks. Money make the hand twisted behind their back. And then they started saying all sorts of, they don't start speaking against bid'ah and its people. Because of why? We're all in the same crowd. We're all getting the same money from the same group and jama'ah, ihya turath, or jam'iyyat, and so on. So, we find the ulama refuting them and finding and clarifying their errors so that people don't fall into their errors. So, may Allah protect the ulama. May Allah protect them, because wallahi, they are khair. Khair upon the ummah is because of ulama. Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu said, لا يأتي زمان إلا والذي بعده أشر منه. There will not be a time except that the year that comes after it is worse. Why? لا يأتي عام. There's not be a year except that the next year is worse. Why? He said, I don't mean rain. One year you have rain, another year you have no rain. I don't mean rulers. One year you have good rulers, another year you have bad rulers. I don't mean that. I mean your ulama will go. Allahu Akbar. You see how he saw the khayriya upon the ummah? It's because of ulama. You see the takfiris? They think it's because of leaders. No. They're all waiting for Salah ad-Din Ayyubi. They're all waiting for some leader to come and take them all out. La yaghi. It starts not from there. It starts from the bottom. It starts from the foundation. Musa alayhi salam, when he was offered leadership and so on, did he accept? Rahmukallah. No, he wants to start with he wants Bani Israel, come with me, Bani Israel, so he could educate them and teach them Tawheed. It wasn't leadership that he was after. He even left their land, the land of Fir'aun. He even wants to leave their land. Take the dunya. You want dunya, take it. My concern is who? It's a faida from Sheikh Muhammad al-Banna, rahimullah. That my concern is the people, the foundation. But the takfir is la. Their foundation is change the ruler, everything will be right. No! Maybe some good will come, yes, but this is not the solution. Is start with the foundation. Start with the people. Start with the asl. And then work you in eventually. Where would the ruler be chosen except from? The mujtama, from the society. So therefore, this is the manhaj of the anbiya. And this is the manhaj of the ulama. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we're on that blessed path. Connected to the ulama. Disconnect, discontinue. You'll be discontinued from the right path. Disconnect, discontinued from the right path. Connect, and inshallah continue upon the right path, upon khair. Wallahu a'lam, wa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ala khayri khalqillah Muhammad, wa akhir da'wana, alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. This question is here. Assalamu alaikum. Alaikum salam. My father has some Sufi-like attributes and doesn't listen to me when I try and give him da'wah about Salafiyya. And now my brothers are starting to mimic him and call me extreme. What do I do? With hikmah, with wisdom, ud'u ila sabili rabbika bil hikmati wal maw'idati al hasana. With wisdom and beautiful preaching. وجادهم بالتي أحسن. Be better than them in your discussions. Sometimes you don't even have to talk. You just leave some tapes, some books. Just leave it lying around. Some literature. And sooner or later, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides whom He wills. It could be anyone. So you have to keep striving, but with good manners. And don't pressure them too much, but rather in a good way. Inshallah, they will know Tawheed. Don't mention names. Because as soon as you say Muhammad Wahhab, they say Wahhabi. Don't mention names. Just start with the Quran, with the ayat, with the ahadith. And then afterwards, slowly, you can mention some of the great scholars of the past, from the first 300-400 years Hijriyah. And slowly, wisdom, hopefully, and dua, supplicating for them, that they are guided. Because dua is powerful, and dua is ibadah. This was a question actually in the other. And as for them calling you extreme, then being on the sunnah is not extreme. Being on the sunnah is salvation. And it's khair. And as for your brothers, slowly, maybe you can pick out one or two. It is your task. It's your jihad, yani your striving that you have to do. Is it permissible to pray behind? Is it permissible to pray an obligatory prayer behind a Sufi? A Sufi, usually they are upon shirk. And they call upon the dead and other than Allah, like the Brelvis, not allowed to pray behind them. The one who has bid'ah, mukaffira in his aqeedah, then you don't pray behind the Sufi. Naam. Salaam to Allah. Shaykh Muhammad al-Banna rahimahullah said there are two types of innovations. The innovation which is ghair mukaffira, yani innovation that doesn't take you out of Islam. Like for example, somebody who uses a bid'ah beads. If you have no one else to pray behind except him, and he's the only one, the imam in the mosque, that's different. Then you can pray behind him. If there's no one better than him, local, you have no other way. That's bid'ah, he said, غير مكفرة. Anyone who has bid'ah غير مكفرة, na'am, Sheikh Muhammad al-Banna rahimahullah said, you can pray behind him. If there's no one else who's better than him, yani Sunni, who has Sunnah, not Bid'ah. But as for Bid'ah Mukaffira, no. You don't pray behind somebody who has innovation in disbelief, in kufr. Like these grave worshippers of Sufis and Brelvis, don't pray behind them. Because it's known, the majority is that what is known about them is that. What is known about them, yani unanimously, is that. Sorry. Don't pray behind them. As for somebody who's ammi and that, no problem, inshallah. And if you have any doubt, then ask. No. Wallahu alam. If you have any corrections or questions before we leave, because I'm traveling tomorrow and we came from far away, so we are and really only to come to see you to yani, spread that, inshallah, that which is khair. But we have things to do, Allah.
Thank you.
Barakallahu feek. Naam, ya khair.
Shaykh, can you just give us a nasihat? Can you ask the importance of Quran, like reading Quran, like the day-to-day basis?
Quran, yes, of course. Quran, the Sahaba would finish it in 1 week. Some of them less than that. Quran, it's important for us to read. The one who reads Quran doesn't read it. Is like the one who's living and the one who's not living. Because the Quran is from the best of the dhikr that one can do. And the Prophet said, Naam, اقرأ القرآن, read the Quran, فإنه يأتي يوم القيامة شفيعا لأصحابه. It will come on the Day of Judgment as an intercessor for his companions, the ones who read it. On the يوم القيامة it will come, subhanAllah, as an intercessor for the one who reads it. Especially we have a particular narration regarding Baqarah and Al Imran. So we read the Quran regularly. Of course, we all need that reminder to read. And each letter you read, لا أقول ألف لام ميم حرف ولكن ألف حرف ولام حرف وميم حرف. And each حرف بعشر حسنة. كل حرف بحسنة والحسنة بعشر أمثالها. Each حرف with a hasana, a reward, and each reward is multiplied 10 times. So how, if you read يعني half a juz or a juz a day, subhanAllah, how many letters, how many hasanat you will get? It's great. And no doubt, thirdly, the Prophet said, خيركم من تعلم القرآن وعلمه. The best of you is he who learns the Quran and he teaches it. And likewise, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he mentioned, الماهر بالقرآن مع سفرة الكرام البررة يوم القيامة. The one who is يعني skillful with the Quran, his good tajweed, he will be with the يعني the righteous, the honorable ones on the day of judgment. And also الذي والذي يقرا القران ويتتعتع فيه وهو عليه شاق فله اجران. The one who reads the Quran and he يعني stutters when while reading it and he tries his best, he will have two rewards. Of course, the reward for the trying and the reward for stuttering, and he still tries even after he stutters. So he will have double reward. And so therefore we must go back to the Quran. Quran is that which will give us yaqeen. Sheikh Saleh Fawzan, actually, he says, I advise everyone to have a pocket Quran. How many times you find yourself in a waiting room, or in a place where time is going by, you are waiting, you are in a queue, you are... Use that time, pick up your pocket Quran and start reading. Maybe you read only one side, maybe you read two sides, maybe you read more than that. So Quran is your protection. Quran is your companion in the sense that you read it regularly and that you memorize that which you are able. And it will be said to the ones who memorize the Quran, read in that which you used to read until the last part that you have read, memorized in this life. So those who have read, no doubt, and memorized much, then inshallah they will be higher in paradise, higher in their levels. And also the Prophet ﷺ, when the battles or expeditions were over, he would bury the Ahlul Qur'an first. And this shows you that Ahlul Qur'an have a status, high status. And the Prophet would look for who are those, where are the reciters, where are the ones who are the Qurra. What mean Qurra? Not like now, they recite but it's no sunnah. They were Qurra ulama, and they had hifd and fahm, and not just reciters, but they were ulama. And they had also memorized. So they would place them in the graves first. Kira, yani, as a honor for them, as a virtue for them. So reading the Quran, no doubt, this is something which must not lose. It's something that we should keep with us always. In Ramadan, for example, to finish the whole Quran and try to take that as an example for the rest of the months. Wallahu a'lam. Naam.
أعوذ بالله. To go as a team, because they said you have to move the people forward, because if they don't study then they'll be off the society. So they say this is necessity. So is there anything
as for riba? No, riba. يعني you're just about to die or what? يعني necessity. Nowadays the word necessity, darura. People want to use it for their own maslaha. Riba ya akhi, falyadhan biharbi min Allah wa Rasul. He's going to prepare himself with the war, with Allah and His Rasul. How are you going to win that war? You will find your life a mess, your children a mess, or your family a mess because of riba. Riba is evil. Riba is is harmful to you in your life. You'll be free from it, far away as possible. Because the one who deals with it, the Prophet said, إِذَا تَبَايَعْتُمْ بِالْعِينَ وَتَمَسَّكْتُمْ بِعَذْنَابِ الْبَقَرِ وَرَضَيْتُمْ بِالزَّرَعِ وَتَرَكْتُمْ الْجِهَادِ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ سَلَّطَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْكُمْ ذُلًّا. Allah will permit your humiliation. Hadith in Sunnah Abi Dawood, which is sahih. Those who deal with usurious transactions like riba. سَلَّطَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ ذُلًّا لَنْ يَنْزِعَ عَنْكُمْ حَتَّى تَرْجِعُ لَدِينِكُمْ. And this whole book is about that hadith. Oh, it mentions that hadith. حَتَّى تَرْجِعُ لَدِينِكُمْ. Until you return to your deen. So being far away from riba, especially these student loans, they entice you to have these loans and then somebody says, I can't pay it back in the end. Now it's a loan, it's a deen. You have to pay it even to the kuffar. If you took money from them, you have to give it back. Give back the rights of those you have taken from them. So, as for studying in mixed environments, then no doubt you're putting yourself in a trial and a fitna situation. But you can now study online. Sheikh Muhammad al-Banna rahmullah said that. He said you can study online. Yani distance learning is made easy now. Don't have to go to university. I don't call it university, I call it uni-diversity. Many people actually go astray in university. And how many, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, people lose their deen when they go to these places? Mixing. Allah, it's not easy. Mixing. Yani, with the men and women mixing together in the same place. And alhamdulillah, Allah, whenever He prohibited something, for a great wisdom, for a great reason. For a great reason. So alhamdulillah, the ayat al-hijab came down, the sahabiyat showed the women as examples how to be, they would not mix with the men, and they would be, whenever they would cover in order to keep away from fitna. And what is the awwal fitna of Bani Israel? It's women. So how you put yourself in a situation of fitna? There are alternatives. Necessity means you're about to die, nothing, you can't do anything else, you know? There's only that way. But no, you have alternatives. Alhamdulillah. So, my advice is the advice of the ulama. Sheikh Salih Fawzan said it's not allowed. No. Yes, brother.
How can a person go into the river can come out from it?
He come out of it, inshallah, by trying his best. Maybe he can get a halal loan. He ask Allah to help him as well, dua. And he can borrow from good people. And he has to just try his best. Maybe if he has a house, sell the house. Naam, to get rid of that if it's possible. If not, he just has to try his best to ask Allah to free him from this. And make tawbah before. In the first instance, to make tawbah to Allah. Because this is a serious crime or major sin. Naam, from the major sins. Naam, ya akhi.
The hadith you said earlier,
لن تدعو بعد أبدا كتاب الله وسنتي.
I heard from someone else that you said the Quran was sunnah. Someone else told me that it was Quran وعترتي.
Quran وإيش؟
عترتي.
ها؟
عترتي.
أيوة.
Could you explain for me the difference between the different narrations or
Quran والسنة على فهم السلف الصالح. This is what we know in the books. Quran, Sunnah, ala fahm as-salaf as-salih. Whoever's bringing anything new, he should bring the proof. And he should tell us what he means by that. What does he mean by that? The one that you heard him say this, what did he say? What was his explanation?
Talking about the Ahlul Bayt wal Abna al-Ad, you're saying that, talking about basically the fadail that they have and what they bring to the deen and the leadership that they should to another.
Yeah, this Rafida, yani. They're like the Rafida, or they are Rafida. Because we say all of Sahaba are pleased. Allah is pleased with them, all. Radiallahu anhum wa radu'an. We don't just specify the Ahl Bayt, even though we love Ahl Bayt. We love Ahl Bayt, the family of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But you see, when they say Ahl Bayt, they don't include Aisha and the rest of the mothers of the believers. They say, no, not Aisha. They only mean Fatima, the daughter of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and his cousins, his uncles. Yani they don't mean his wives, which goes against the Quran. So they are not true followers of the Sahaba. So are we trying to limit? Is it correct then that we only limit the deen, the understanding of the deen to the Quran and the family of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Abu Bakr was yani not directly from the family of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but yet he was the first Khalifa. Does that mean then it shouldn't be him that was the first Khalifa? It should be Ali radhiyallahu anhu. No, because Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he would say to Aisha radhiyallahu anha, O'mur Abu Bakr bis salah. Order Abu Bakr with the salah. He didn't say O'mur Ali. With the salah, with the leadership. Even though there were others who had memorized more Quran. But he said, O'mur Abu Bakr bis salah. And when he saw him leading the Muslims in the prayer, He smiled. The Prophet was pleased with Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu. And the rest of the Sahaba, Umar ibn Khattab, Na'am, Prophet would say that they are the two martyrs, Umar Khattab and Uthman, radiallahu anhu, the two martyrs after me. Because he said, with me is Siddiq and two martyrs. Who are they? Umar ibn Khattab and Uthman ibn Affan, the two martyrs. Prophet called them martyrs. They don't want to accept that. So, عليكم بسنتي وسنة الخلفاء الراشدين المهديين, which is in Sunan Abi Dawood and Sunan Ibn Majah and Muslim Imam Ahmad, and it is sahih that we hold on to the Sunnah of Rasulullah SAW and the Sunnah of the Khulafa al-Rashidin. Not only the Ahl Bayt is not sufficient. If you say that, then you are Rafidi or you have Tashayyu in you. We don't limit the Sahaba to only the family of Rasulullah SAW. So the one who said that, tell him, put it back in your pocket. Barakallahu fiqh. Naam, ya. We can't, they say we can't be Salafi because Allah has named you Muslims. Yes, Allah named you Muslims, but you are Muslim, Sunni or Shi'i. He will say Sunni, say, well, did Allah say that? Directly like that? No. But indirectly, Allah Azza wa Jalla has called you not to only the generality. Yes, be Muslim, but the true Islam. Be Muslim, but the specific Islam that Rasulullah came with. So, upon Sunnah, upon the way of the Salaf al-Salih, so just say, Salafi, ya akhi, riyahni wa riyah al-nas. Make it easy for me and easy for everybody else, because the ya is ya nisba, ya of ascription. You're not saying anything else except that I'm following the Sahaba. Understanding of Islam. I didn't change. The ulama mentioned this in the past. In Sir Alam al-Nubala, when Imam al-Dahabi mentioned about great scholars, he would say, for example, Abdullah Mubarak al-Salafi. I didn't say that. I came 700 years later from Sir Alam al-Dahabi. We didn't say that. Ibn Taymiyyah, who died 728 Hijriya, he is the one who said, لا عيب لمن انتسب إلى مذهب السلف واعتز إليه بل يجب قبول ذلك منه. There's no harm in ascribing to the manhaj al-Salaf. That's what you're doing, ascribing to it. And the Prophet said to Aisha, said to Fatima, his daughter, "Ana ni'ma salaf laki." So the Prophet already used that word salaf. So what's your problem? And Allah Subhanahu wa Taala used the word salaf in the Quran. He mentioned the word salaf in the Quran. So what's your problem with the word salaf? You have a problem with the best people. But the same people, they have no problem with ascribing to their country. They say, I am Maghrabi, I am Hindi, I am Pakistani, I am Jazairi, I am Britani, I am Amriki. He has no problem with that. To ascribe to a country. But he doesn't want to ascribe to the Sahaba way. He doesn't want to describe to the best people. The Sahaba and the Tabi'een and the Tabi Tabi'een. Would love to be with them. Would love to be followers of these great Sahaba radiallahu anhum. La'ib. Volume 4, page 149 of Majmu' Fatawa. لا عيب لمن أظهر مذهب السلف واعتز إليه. Rather, you should, as obligatory for you to accept that from them. So we are not inventing, we are following. اتبعوا ولا تبتدعوا فقد كفيتم. Ibn Mas'ud رضي الله عنه said, follow and do not innovate, for you have been sufficed. What is sufficient for them is sufficient for you. As Shariq the Qadi, when it was said to him, a group of Mu'tazila deny that Allah, that the believers will see Allah. They deny that Allah descends in the last third part of the night. He said, tell them, I have nothing to do with it. Tell them, as for us, we take our deen from the sons of the Tabi'een. We take our deen from the sons of the Sahaba, from the Sahaba. Where do they take their deen from? So this one here who says, no, I am only Muslim. Ask him, because he can't deny it. You're Muslim, Sunni or Shi'i. Ask him. He will say Sunni. Sunni upon the way of the Ash'aris or the way of the Salaf? You say upon the way of the Salaf. So Alhamdulillah. What then, instead of saying I am Muslim upon the understanding of Sunnah, upon the way of Sunnah, and the understanding of the way of the Salaf. This is long. And the Prophet said, خَيْرُ كَلَامَ أَقَلْ وَدَلْ. The best speech is that which is concise and to the point. Salafi. That's it. Salafi. It's concise and to the point. What's the problem? We did not change. They changed. They changed. Because ulama of the past, they didn't have a problem with this. Go to Shaykh Ibn Uthaymeen rahimahullah in his Aqidah al-Wasitiyah, page 34. He said, the one who follows the Quran, the Sunnah, على فهم السلف إنه سلفي. So what's the problem? Shaykh Ibn Uthaymeen rahimahullah قالها. And before him, many scholars have said it. إيش مشكلة يا أخي. You have a problem? Then you must change, not us. Alhamdulillah, we are followers of the great, inshallah, Sahaba, great people ever to be, from those who came after them, inshallah. Naam. And if somebody says, I'm not Salafi, I'm not saying I'm Salafi, then maybe he's not Salafi anyway, so leave him. Naam.
What's the best way of getting married?
Getting married, then a man marries for four things. For her jamal, for her status, for her beauty, for her status, and for her wealth or for her deen. فَدْفَرْ بِدَاتِ الدِّينِ. Then choose the woman who has the deen. If she has extra after that, no problem. But first is deen. فَدْفَرْ بِدَاتِ الدِّينِ. And if you're not able to get married, then fast. So getting married is by, if you have family, like your sister, your mother, somebody pointed out to you a particular sister who's good, and not through the internet. Some people now on the internet, mashallah, it's become very easy now, huh? People on the internet, you don't even know who's behind the screen. Maybe you go, maybe it's a man there. Oh. Alhamdulillah, it could be true, it could be a man. And all that time you say, Habibti and all this, and she's a man. And it's a man. So don't go down that path, causing destruction for yourself. You don't want to go down that path. Masallah salama. Protect yourself, ya akhwan. Protect yourselves. Fitna. Switch this off. Protect yourselves. Because shaitan will come to you. And he will misguide you. Slowly, slowly. Until, first of all, it's just, salam alaikum. And then after that is more. So be careful. Your family, contact her family, her wali. Because man ataakum, man tardawna deenahu wa khulaqah. Whoever comes to you and you are pleased with his deen and his manners. How can you see a man's deen from the internet? How? And his manners from the internet. Maybe he's rude or whatever, that's something else. But I'm saying, Prophet said, man ataakum. Shaykh Al-Bayn Hafidhullah said, this is proof that you go to the family of the one you want to get married to, the makhtuba. You go to them, not from far away, but you go to them. So if you have sisters, if you have daughters, then you expect them, whoever wants to come in the hammer, they come to you. So then you ask about that individual. You inquire about them. And sisters, don't be gullible, don't be vulnerable. Because wallahi, how many were messed up and their lives were messed up and children came and then the person left them because the man was a player, was a la'ab. So be careful. And the brothers as well. Don't just look for beauty or look for status or wealth. That all goes. And it could go. But her deen. فَظْفَرْ بِدَاتِ الدِّينِ. Her akhlaq, her good manners. This is what you look for first and foremost. So how do you get married? Wallahi, it's not easy. It's not easy. If you can, do Hajj on Arafah, ask Allah to help you. Choose a good wife. Wallahi, akhwan, the matter is so serious. It's not easy. But do it through family, your members of family that you know, and ask about her through your sisters, through your family members, your female members, to ask and inquire and follow up. That way, inshallah, hopefully she's a good sister and your good brother and, you know, وَالطَّيِّبُونَ لِلطَّيِّبَاتِ The good for the good, inshallah. No. Yes, ya akhi. He's not from Kuwait. Muhammad Saleh al-Munajjid. He's from Khobar.
Islam Kuwait.
Yes, but he is from Khobar. He lives in Khobar. In Saudi Arabia, in the eastern province. Are you allowed to take from him? I would not take from him. Because the scholars have told us not to take from him, so we don't take from him. From them, Sheikh Rabi Hafidhullah advised us, don't take from him. So we don't take from him. because he's upon the path, praise it, Yahani, of the, as Sheikh Rabi said, the Qutubis. He made a book called Islah al-Buyut, and in that book he said, when you make an established Islamic home, you should have a library, and in that library you should have the books of Sayyid Qutb. And we know the books of Sayyid Qutb have lots of political errors and aqidah errors before that, manhaj errors. But as for taking from him, no. So don't take from him. Take from Sheikh bin Baz, Sheikh bin Uthaymeen, Sheikh al-Albani, take from Sheikh Salif Uzan, Sheikh al-Haydan, Sheikh Rabi, Sheikh Ubaid, Sheikh Muhammad Hadi. All these are ulama, they praise each other, they know each other. Alhamdulillah, Ma'rufun, Sheikh Abdul Muhsin, and others. Take from those who follow them upon righteousness. As for taking from Munaid, no. And remember, many years ago, he gave a lecture in Khobar itself, and during the time of Sheikh Al-Bani, when he passed away, and he spoke about, he said, the students, the real students of Sheikh Al-Bani, and he referred to those who are actually afflicted with the misunderstanding of yani political situation, and so he referred to them. He referred to them yani as the students of Sheikh Al-Bani, but in reality they went astray. So how you refer to them? How is it that you refer to them? So don't take from him. Save yourself from two things, from doubts and desires. These are people of doubts, they will give you doubt. And Allah knows best. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك. جزاكم الله خيرا وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين. What is the production start on Nasheed? Do you hold the There's free book, huh? Take it with you, inshallah. Thank you.